Have a seat.
Thank you. Ah, well, Pop had it right. Yard chores are easier when you make a home movie out of them. We just made our first, you won't see it here because these are Pop's movies, but we just made our first home movie of how to put leaves in the truck. We must point out, however, that there is a tarp lining the bed of the truck and coming up at the front end of the bed, so that when we get to the dump, we simply pull on the tarp, all the leaves come off the end, of course we lower the tailgate first, and everybody else at the dump turns Forestry Service green with envy when they see our method.
So jealous. They just stop their raking and shoveling, picking at their puny little piles of leaves, and we're there, we swoop in, get our leaves off, and leave, and wave goodbye, and yes. Coffee in one hand.
Fills us with pity. Anyway, this one was very hard to make, mostly because the films were very old. Some of them virtually disintegrated as they went through the projector. They were probably hard to watch, too, because of the poor quality. This disc will have some better quality films. But, you know, you can jump around on the disc. That's why DVD players have controls that allow you to do that. I wanted to point out that one of the films is the first color film, and then there are three or so that are not color, and that's because during World War II, materials including color films were scarce. So you can follow that progress of World War II by the films. There are an inordinate number of pictures of young Billy Raley, and that's probably because the gas shortage didn't permit Mom and Pop to take road trips. Again, you've got a fast-forward button, so you can't lose. The little guy holding my hand is none other than Cousin Jim. It's great that he made his appearance. I wanted to point out that the sailboat, I believe, that Edie was playing with on the first disc is the same one that I'm playing with on the second disc at Guilford, where it lived until Mom and Pop and Aunt Edie and Uncle Jim sold Guilford, and then it lived on my desk in our room in Riverside, Connecticut, for several years, where it stayed upright while the house was being moved, because I had forgotten to lie it down before I went to school. Oh, who knows? Mysterious are these origins of the bug to sail that I have and Ben has too. And speaking of Ben, you can see that Ben comes by his desire to climb honestly in some of these clips also. So, have fun, and we'll see you at the beginning of disc three.
Yay! We got the leaves done!
Yeah!
Bye. We love you. You come back here, Bill, real soon. Turn that thing off. I have this fantasy.